I didn't even say which project I was working on.
Hey,
how's it going?
Welcome back. If you're new, hey,
what's up?
You should subscribe because you're awesome and I'm awesome and let's be awesome together. Hey, what's up, my writing friends? Welcome back to my authortube channel. I'm Autumn Ashley, and today I'm going to be talking about what I'll be doing for Camp NaNo this April. When I first sat down to start brainstorming what I wanted to do for next month, I wanted to finish the re-outline that I'm doing for my current project. I wanted to do a character outline. I also wanted to start outlining the key scenes and maybe the big battles that are gonna happen in the story. Then I got to thinking about it. And I didn't want to do that. I kind of wanted to spice it up a little bit, and my idea of spicing it up for Camp April was going to be this.
Do I have your attention now?
Good. Because this is important. What I decided to do for Camp April instead of outlining characters and novels and scenes that are going to be important at some point in the story, what I decided to do instead of that is I'm going to journal as my character every day. I have plans to finish this re-outline at the end of March. There was no reason to push it off until April. That's unnecessary. The outlining method that I used was a 3-act, 9-block, 27-chapter structure. The first chapter is going to be day one, and then day two is going to be the next chapter, and so forth and so on. I know what you're thinking, Autumn, there are 30 days in April, and there's only 27 blocks to the 27 chapter structure. Don't worry, I got you covered. I'm going to write a prologue and I'm going to write an epilogue. That's 2 days right there, and then that gives me one day where I need to play catch up or I can do whatever, go over everything, add a little bit to the journal entries, whatever. The world is my oyster and I am going to embrace it. I'm going to give you guys a novel update later, but just to say, I've been struggling with this story and I've had to go back and re-outline it. I didn't want the same problem to happen that happened the first time. My way of handling and trying to prevent what happened last time from happening this time after I re-outline, I want to actually get inside the head of my main character. And the best way that I felt like I could do that is to journal as my character. So for each chapter, I'm going to be my character and document kind of how she feels, what's going on, other characters that she, you know, she maybe had a conversation with and it's something that she remembered. Doing that for an entire month is going to get me so much closer to my main character than any type of character outline or any type of building battle scenes is ever going to do. I need to get to know this character the best I possibly can. And I feel like journaling every day as this character is definitely going to get me there.
I would like to pause for a moment and tell you that you are awesome. And if you think this video is awesome, and if you think that I am awesome, you should like the video and you should subscribe so you can see more amazing content. I'm gonna give you guys the novel update. I didn't even say which project I was working on. The project that I'm working on is Project Brina, and Project Brina is a standalone fantasy that I've been working on. It is essentially this cult is slowly starting to take over this princess's kingdom, and she has to save her family and her father and her kingdom from this evil cult. I had a dream about this story at the end of 2019, and I actually didn't start outlining the story until April of 2020. Almost a year ago, I started actually working on this story. Camp July of 2020, I started writing my first draft, or as I call it, my draft zero. I wrote about 50,000 words up until the end of last year. I took a little bit of a break, and then when I started this year, part of my Q1 goals was to finish my first draft, or draft zero. When I sat down to actually start writing the story again, I realized I ended up writing myself into a corner and I wasn't really sure how to get myself out of it. I had way too many storylines, way too many things, not good pacing, which I know that these are all things that happen with your first draft and or your draft zero and you have to push through it. I feel like this was a major issue and that if I kept going, I was just going to bring myself further and further into a hole that I was eventually gonna have to dig myself out of. I took it upon myself just to stop writing. I talked to one of my other authortube friends. She gave me good advice and I decided what I needed to do was re-outline my entire story. At the end of March, I set for myself to finish that outline. It has been a journey. It has been a wild ride. I have bebopped around in this entire video. I am trying to work on lighting and figuring out where's the best angle. So I'm glad that you guys have stuck with me through this. I really, really want to vlog the entire experience of journaling as my main character. I might miss a few days. Things happen. Not a big deal. I am going to really, really try to vlog the entire experience and to give you guys regular updates on how it's going. I'm going to link the playlist playlist that I have for this project. I came up with this playlist a while ago. Well, lies. I just created the playlist, but a lot of these songs I've already been listening to when I am trying to get inspired, just, you know, wanting to listen to it as I'm thinking about a certain scene. But I want to share this playlist with you guys because I think it is excellent. If you write fantasy, I hope that some of these songs end up making it on your list as well because they are really, really awesome. You should totally check them out, but I will leave that linked in the description box below. And I have one final announcement for everybody. I will be hosting an all-day write-a-thon on my AuthorTube channel Saturday, April 24th. With a whole bunch of my other AuthorTube friends. We're going to do 3 writing sprint sessions, and those 3 writing sprint sessions are going to be 3 hours long each. It's all going to be in Eastern Standard Time, and it's going to be 9 a.m. to noon, 3 p.m. Eastern Standard Time to 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Take another 3-hour break so you can get up, do other things, hydrate, be healthy, eat, whatever you gotta do, take a nap. Then we're gonna come back from 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, and then we are going to write until midnight. I hope that you guys are going to be able to join us in this all-day write-a-thon. I will leave that playlist linked down below. Please be sure to set those reminders and you can come and hang out with my other 2 friends and I, and we're going to have a great, awesome day. I'm very, very excited for it, and I'm very excited for everybody to join us as well. Woo! Very bright. That's a little softer. And that is going to wrap up everything for this video. Let me know if you guys are going to be participating in this camp, and if you are, let me know what you are going to be working on. Give me a description and a little teaser of your project. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you want to see more content, definitely hit that notification bell, hit the like button, and subscribe to my channel so you can see more of my content. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.